I'm at it again. We're just gonna make some DIY brine shrimp hatcheries. We got a drilled hole in our cap. We're gonna silicone that because I got a drill bit that's a little bit big, so we ain't gonna be using that. So we can get our hose out here. We'll take our check valve, put it on there so we can only get air going in, nothing coming back into your pump. What I did a little different than most people, I cut the 2-liter bottle at the very top, used another bottle down on the bottom, because that way there you got this little lip up here. If it does bubble up, that'll kind of hold it inside instead of letting it go out and make a mess everywhere, kind of keep the salt from the air stone or whatever you're going to use. I'm just going to bubble it. But basically DIY shrimp hatchery, really cheap, easy, should be effective. I don't see why it wouldn't. I'll probably use an air stone right now because I want to silicone this and I want to get some brine shrimp going. I'll show you guys why in a minute. But let me get this set up and we'll go ahead and try this. Okay guys, we're going to do this all wrong now. What we're going to use regular salt. Not iodized, just regular salt. Yeah, I know you ain't supposed to do it that way, but that's what I'm going to do. We use 1 2/3 tablespoon of salt. Gets delayed good enough. That's close enough. We're going to use 1 liter of water. We got about a liter of water here. Dechlorinated. I'll be right back. I'm going to do that. I'm going to drop the brine stir. I'm going to put it on air stone. I got the other one drilled, but I'm going to do that later. Just for ease of doing it, we're going to put an air stone in here tonight. The next one, when we do the next batch, we'll have the other ones made. I said to go 1 2/3 of rock salt, but I didn't have any rock salt. There's what you should use, half teaspoon. Incubated 80 degrees, that's pretty close to our room temperature. Near here. Pretty much know how to do all that. Came in a little handy scoop. Should be good. That's all I'm gonna put it in anyways. Put these back in the refrigerator so they stay fresh. tonight or wait till this all gets going with how many brine shrimp we get and see if the salt works. I thought I'd go get some rock salt. Ain't that big of a deal. Back in the 80s I used it and it worked just fine, so I don't think it'd be too much difference now. We'll see. Always like put me one of these in here, just kind of keep the spray down. I really ain't gotta even have that on there. I put that up there, that way there anything that bounces around, sprays around or whatever, can fall right back in there. I get all over my tank, fuck it up. But anyways, I don't know if I'm just gonna make a short video on this or I'll just wait until I get everything done right. Let's see if we get some brine shrimp. Catch you back later. Well, how's it going, guys? Just looking at the baby angelfish. Yes, they look like angelfish. Of course, it ain't gonna focus. It's always gonna focus on the background. So these little baby fish up here. Yeah, I know. Hey, we got one in there for a focus for a split second. But anyways, there are about 25 of them. They're all doing good. Try to focus by hand with one hand and hold the camera. There you guys go. That's it. That's probably all you're going to get for it just by how to poke. But they're growing. But the real reason for this video is up here, these guys here. I don't know if I can get in there or not and focus or not. See on there. Of course, I can't even see the camera sitting here. Let's see if I can get in here without him photobombing me. Where are we? What we're looking for? Oh, the light on there, you just can't see it. Maybe you can now. There's probably 400 eggs again, guys. These ones here look like they're doing good. They ain't turned white. Been almost 24 hours, so we should be good on this run. So I'll probably be removing the parents the next day or two. Just let them hatch out in this tank. I'll probably get in here and drain the tank one more time. Clean out the little bit of food they didn't eat and move them back into the angelfish tank. But anyways, guys, that's what the whole video was about. Hope you enjoyed. Just a quick update. Later, buds. Finally, there we go. Definitely have baby brine shrimp moving around. Yeah, I can't hold it still, guys. That's okay. But that rumor there proved out fine. You can use table salt. That's brine shrimp. Don't need rock salt. You gotta have marine salt. There's more brine shrimp in there than you can shake a stick at. That's for you southerners, so you know what I'm talking about. Woohoo.